This video is brought to you by the Research School of Chemistry at the Australian National University. In this part of the experiment, we'll be extracting trimeristin from whole nutmeg seeds and then recrystallizing it. First, we need to grind up our nutmeg to allow for easier chemical extraction. Weigh out about 5 grams of whole nutmeg seeds on the mass balance. You should need about 1 or 2 seeds. Transfer this to a mortar and pestle. Try not to hammer the pestle onto the seeds, but instead twist and grind to get fine particles. Make sure there are no huge chunks, then transfer your powder to a 100ml conical flask. First, tip it out onto a weighing paper, using a spatula to scrape off anything that's stuck on the mortar. Then fold it into a cone and transfer it into your flask. Hot tip. Put another weighing paper under your flask to catch any fallout, and then use that to funnel it back in. Now we need to actually extract the trimeristin from the powder. Take the flask and a 50ml beaker to the fume hood, and add 50ml of diethyl ether using a pump pack. Take it back to your bench and swirl for 10 minutes. Ether is quite toxic, so cover the top with a beaker to control the fumes. While you're waiting, set up your gravity filtration using a 100ml conical flask, a glass funnel, and a large filter paper. Flute your filter paper to maximize the surface area for filtration. Here's one we prepared earlier. Grow an extra hand to hold down the filter, and then pour the mixture through the funnel in small batches. Be careful not to overload the filter, and make sure you put the beaker back on the flask to stop the ether fumes. Wash the flask with 10ml of diethyl ether to wash out any leftover product. When it's done dripping, discard the gunk in the contaminated waste container. This yellow filtrate is your trimeristin product. Now we need to evaporate off the solvent and recrystallize the product. Take the flask to the fume hood, add a boiling stick, and place it on the boiling water bath. While you're waiting for it to boil, clean up your glassware and set up your vacuum filtration station. When the diethyl ether is done evaporating, discard the boiling stick in the sharps container and add 5ml of acetone to the warm yellow oil. Take it back to your bench and cool in an ice bath until it recrystallizes. Cool some spare acetone while you're at it. You might need to scratch the bottom of the flask with a glass rod to help your product crash out. Vacuum filter your product as usual. Since acetone has a low boiling point, use a light vacuum to avoid evaporating all of your solvent into the vacuum system. Use your ice-cold acetone to wash out your flask and get out as much product as possible. The crystals are dry when they stop sticking to the spatula. Carefully collect your crystals in a pre-weighed vial, making sure you scrape the filter paper, and record the mass and yield. Stick your label on your vial and admire your white trimeristin crystals. We'll be right back.